Kubeflow is all about creating a portable and scalable environment for your machine learning workflows. Let's take a look at how to set up and get started working with Kubeflow. Today, we'll talk about how to set up Kubeflow and then go through deployment. If you want to check out the documentation directly, check out the link below to read more about setting up Kubeflow. Now, one of the key goals of Kubeflow is to be portable so you can run your ML workflow anywhere. More specifically, it can be run anywhere Kubernetes can be run, which is a whole lot of places, like running a Kubernetes cluster on-prem or a managed Kubernetes service in the cloud. You can use the kfctl command line interface to set up Kubeflow on your cluster. Kfctl is flexible, so you can install it on a variety of environments. But it's a command line tool, and it takes some additional configuration. So let's take a look at another way to install. We'll go with the GUI option and use the Google Cloud Deployer. This quick form can get you quickly set up with Kubeflow after just filling out some information. Once we click the Sign In with Google button, we'll be prompted for some access, since Kubeflow will be deploying resources to our Google Cloud project. If you don't want to use this web deployer, check out that link below for other ways to deploy. Now we can see the specific information needed to deploy. The first thing we'll need is the project to deploy into. If you're just playing around with Kubeflow, I recommend creating a new Google Cloud project so you have a safe sandbox to play around in. There's a link in the description to help you through that if you're not familiar with creating projects. In addition, you'll need to be a project owner and make sure this project has billing enabled, since the default deployment currently comes with more resources than the free trial allows. Don't worry, you can always remove the deployment when you're done testing things if you'd like. The first box is where we'll put the ID of the Google Cloud project where we want to deploy Kubeflow, and the second contains the name for the deployment. We could change it if we had multiple clusters or other tools in the project, but the default name is Kubeflow, so let's leave that as is. There's also another option for how to connect. You can choose IAP, which stands for Identity Aware Proxy, or just choose a username and password. If you're just playing around and learning, go ahead and choose username and password to save some time. Otherwise, you'll want to use IAP for things like your production environment and to protect any sensitive data. After that, you can choose your zone and version, or just leave them as is, and click Create Deployment. This could take up to half an hour, but you'll see a window pop up at the bottom with a bit more information about what's going on. Behind the scenes, Kubeflow is creating all the resources you'll need, including the Kubernetes cluster and service accounts. Let's switch to a deployment that we've already created. After logging in with our selected connection option, we'll get the Kubeflow interface. There's a lot of options here, and we'll start to go over the different components and dive into some of them deeper in our next videos. Just to make sure everything's working, let's quickly launch a Jupyter Notebook interface. First, choose a namespace in the top left. One will be created for you through the setup. After that, just click on Notebook Servers and click New Server. We can give it a simple name like Test and then launch it. It can take a few minutes to launch since it's handling all of the work of creating the computing resources you'll need to run it. Once the notebook server is up, we can connect and then create a simple Python notebook. As you can see, everything is working and we haven't had to run any commands to create the necessary resources that are needed to run the notebook. It can be pretty straightforward to set up Kubeflow, and it helps abstract you from the manual steps when growing your ML workflows. Don't forget, you can go to Deployment Manager in the Google Cloud Console to delete the deployment if you want to shut everything down. Just take a look for the deployment name you specified in the web UI. The default name is just Kubeflow. In the next video, we'll talk more about the different components in Kubeflow. Check out the links below to try it out for yourself.